do you start a house cleaning company after COVID? We're going to talk about that today. Hi there, I'm Angela Brown, and this is Ask a House Cleaner. This is a show where you get to ask a house cleaning question, and I get to help you find an answer. Now, today's show is brought to us by this book. It's called How to Start Your Own House Cleaning Company, and this is the paperback book. The paperback book costs money, but you can download the ebook of this free of charge on Amazon. I will leave links in the show notes. But it's called How to Start Your Own House Cleaning Company, and it's all the ins and outs of what you do as you're starting your house cleaning company if this is brand new to you. But now, based on this book, I'm going to go a little bit off book, and I'm going to tell you what the differences and the nuances are now that we've been through COVID. All right, so there are a couple of things that are not in the book, because obviously, when the book was written, there was no COVID. But right now, we're discovering something very unique for the very first time ever. There are a lot of public school systems. I know this is true in Charlotte, North Carolina, where I live. There are a lot of public school systems that are having kids come back to school one day a week. And so their parents are going to be homeschooling for the other 4 days a week with the teachers working together to get the education that their children needs. What that means is the parents are not going back to work, or they are going to have to swap babysitting with neighbors and friends and other homeschooling parents. And so there are parents that are now scrambling saying, I'm going to be at home all day. I can't work my regular job. So there are a lot of people that are now getting into the house cleaning business, and they want to know, what am I supposed to do next? All right, so very first, we got to figure out the kid situation if you have kids. And so what's happening is we have partners right now, and there are collaborative agreements, which is super exciting, of parents that their kids carpooled before, okay? So they know each other, they're neighbors, they live in the same area. And so the kids can walk to and from each other's houses as they did in the past to get together for the school carpool. All right, so the parents are saying, well, I've got to be home now all these days a week with my kids. Why don't you take my kids one day, I'll take the kids the other day, and we'll both find jobs and we'll work on the opposite days so that while you're watching my kids, I can go clean houses and vice versa, okay? So there are partnerships that are coming together for the first time in a really communal sort of way where everybody has to work together because of the new situation that has presented itself. Okay, so I'm super excited about this because it's happening all over. There are little pockets of neighbors that are starting to work together. Well, the glory of this is if you have two or three moms that are working together and all their kids are at one house, what that says is they can all work as a team together and they can go in and they can work and clean two, three, four homes in a day. Okay. So either those can be your employees or you can rotate and you work one day and they work the other day. So it's working either solo or as a team. All right. So the next thing that we have to consider is there's a lot of information if you have been an employee and you're now going to be a business owner. Now, I would be foolish if I tried to trick you into thinking that running a cleaning business was like so much fun and super easy, because it's not. It's actually running a business. And so there's a lot of details that are involved. Now, I don't want to scare you away from it, but there's a lot of information that you don't have yet. And this is if you've never had a business. So you're going to be thinking about, what about a website? And what about graphics? And what do I do for social media? And all of those things. The good news is all of your other neighbors are probably in a similar situation. And so there are a lot of neighbors that can help each other. And so, hey, listen, I'm in kind of a bind in that I'm going to be home with the kids and we're putting together this neighborhood collective effort. Is there anyone here in the neighborhood that knows graphic design? I promise there's somebody that knows. Is there anybody here that knows how to set up web pages? I promise there's somebody who knows, okay? So you can start tapping into your neighbors, and as you pay them either in babysitting or you pay them, you know, bits of money or whatever that you earn, what happens is they can help you put together something right now because they too are out of work. They too are going to be home with the kids during the school year, right? So you can have one person that gets paid that sets up all of the neighbors' websites, or one person that does all of the graphic design. There's probably somebody that's really great with social media. And so that person can help you put together the graphics and the memes and the little GIFs and all that stuff for your website to keep your social media pages going to generate interest. There are probably places that you go as neighbors, either like an HOA association meeting, or if you have like a Facebook page for the neighborhood where you can all work together. Is there anyone here who is looking for house cleaning because we have three moms in our neighborhood that are starting a cleaning company and they'll be working together? There's something very comforting about hiring your neighbors because you know they're not going to steal from you because, like, you know where they live, right? You just go repossess your stuff. They're not going to rip you off because they have to see you. Your kids go to school together. I mean, there's this built-in level of trust, right? So there are some really, really great things that are coming out of this pandemic. And I'm super excited because as frustrating as it has been, there is a huge opportunity that lies inside of what we're all experiencing right now. And so if you have been thinking about starting a business, even if it's not house cleaning, maybe you are the web designer that could help the house cleaners in the neighborhood. Maybe you know about social media and you're really great with putting things on a schedule, sending out posts at a regular time. Maybe you're great with running a Facebook group. Maybe there are different skills that you have to offer. I know there's a photographer that we're working with right now that was a house cleaner at one point, but she's now going to be a full-time homeschooler because, you know, her kid goes to school now one day a week. And so the other 4 days a week, she must be home. But she'll be doing a lot of before and after pictures and putting together collages and putting together moving animated art and stuff like that because that's her background and that's her skill. And so whatever your skills are, this is the time to come forward and to put together your own little portfolio and to say, hey, I'm available if there's anyone in the neighborhood that needs this new element of my business. And then, of course, a step beyond that is Fiverr. Fiverr is the gig economy where you put up your own little website on Fiverr and they have an escrow account where somebody pays for your service. And only after you've delivered the service and they've approved of the job do you get your money. But you never go into a job going, I hope I get paid. The money is already there and you can advertise whatever it is, whether it's blog work, like maybe you write blogs, maybe you do photography, maybe you do before and after pictures, maybe you put together videos, maybe you do social media, maybe you put together courses online. There are a whole bunch of different things that people are willing to pay for, and it doesn't just have to be the people that are in your neighborhood. And so this could be anywhere on the globe. I know I've hired people from Fiverr and there are people that are in Brazil and Lithuania and different countries and they have helped me do services that I didn't have the immediate help for. So I'm like, super awesome. There's somebody here that's skilled and qualified and knows exactly how to work with me on my time schedule. So the world of opportunity is open. And I'm really excited as we move forward through this pandemic era, the technology that it's forcing all of us to learn. There are a lot of people, like even my mom, who has now gone on Zoom and she's becoming very proficient on Instant Messenger with Facebook. And I mean, before it was this big scary thing to her, but there are a lot of people now that are embracing the technology. And so now you can run a business, even if you've had no business experience whatsoever. There are also websites that I would like to clue you into, and I will leave links in the show notes to this as well. But the Small Business Administration has a help guide if you're starting a business after COVID, as does the Chamber of Commerce website. And so I will leave links to both of those in the show notes as well. But if you're thinking about starting a cleaning business or starting a business after COVID, there's never been a better time than right now because everyone has to pull together and work together with the resources that we have available to us in order to make it go. And everyone everywhere is in the same boat. So we all have to work together. It's pretty awesome. All right, if you found this helpful, please pass it on to a friend. If we've earned your subscription, please subscribe. And until we meet again, leave the world a cleaner place than when you found it.